Do you give people who make this case that that was the beginning and that there had to be something that provoked the beginning, do you give them an A at least for trying to reconcile faith and reason?
I don't think they're reconcilable.
What do you mean?
Well, so let me say that differently. All efforts that have been invested by brilliant people of the past have failed at that exercise. They just fail. And so the track record is so poor that going forward I have essentially zero confidence, near zero confidence, that there will be fruitful things to emerge from the effort to reconcile it.
Before you respond, what do you think the probability is that he's read Where the Conflict Really Lies by Alvin Plantinga?
Zero. I mean, it's very, very clear that Dr. Tyson is not well-read in this area. He's just sharing his opinion. And that's evident in the way the question is framed. Faith and reason, are they reconcilable? Those are such general terms as to be meaningless. What in the world is even meant by faith and reason? And yet he thinks they're irreconcilable. Now, what he goes on to talk about is the opening chapter of Genesis. That is apparently what he thinks he means by faith, and that all efforts to reconcile that with science have failed. Now, there's a lot to be said about this. As the interviewer suggested, the idea that the universe had a beginning at some point in the finite past and was created by God, as Genesis declares, is fully reconcilable with modern astrophysical cosmology, which also posits an absolute origin to the universe about 13.8 billion years ago. Also, the fine-tuning of the universe is consistent with the biblical affirmation that it's God who is the ultimate creator of the universe and all of its biological life forms. The extraordinary applicability of mathematics that we've talked about on previous Capturing Christianities is also completely reconcilable and compatible with a religious perspective on creation, such as you have in Genesis 1. So it's demonstrably false that faith and modern science cannot be reconciled, as the way Dr. Tyson says. Now, with respect to the Genesis account, it's very important to understand that this is not offering a natural account of the origin of the world. This is an account that works with the presuppositions of the culture and the assumptions that were made by those to whom it was written to make the theological point that the stars and the sun and the moon, the animals, the things in the world are not deities, as was believed in ancient Mesopotamia, but rather these are just ordinary, natural things which the transcendent God has made. And that central theological point is not dependent upon the sort of worldview assumptions that may be taken for granted in this chapter. It's not a chapter about cosmology or biology. It's a chapter about how God is the source of the things in the natural world, and that therefore they are not to be worshipped.
We have a couple minutes. Why don't we talk for just a couple minutes about the evolutionary argument against naturalism and why Plantinga thinks that science is ultimately in conflict with naturalism as opposed to theism?
Yes, this is a very subtle argument that Plantinga has defended in great depth. And it's basically this. If naturalism is true, then our cognitive faculties have been selected for survival value, not for truth. It's ultimately irrelevant whether or not our beliefs are true. What matters is only if they are beneficial in the struggle for survival. And so what Plantinga says is that if naturalism is true, we can have no confidence in the reliability of our cognitive faculties. But if that's the case, then we can have no confidence in the truth of naturalism, because the belief in naturalism was formed by those very cognitive faculties, which are shown to be unreliable if naturalism is true. So there is a kind of vicious circularity here, a kind of self-referential incoherence that is inescapable on a naturalistic worldview, because naturalism will undermine the reliability of the very cognitive faculties that were used to establish naturalism.